Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So hello and good morning students. We saw the effect of acceleration, we saw the formula for it, HA. Now we'll see what is the effect of acceleration at the suction end and at the delivery end. So first we'll be looking at the effect of acceleration at the suction side. So we saw a new head called as acceleration head. We already had two heads, that is HS and HD. HS is suction head, HD was delivery head. Now we came across one more head, that is the acceleration head. This is the head that we get because of the acceleration of the fluid inside the suction pipe, or you can say the delivery pipe. So we are talking about the suction end first. So when the pump is pumping the water from the reservoir, it has to deliver head of HS. That means the pump has to create a vacuum that is equal to HS, also equal to HA, that is it also has to overcome the acceleration head. So the total head that the pump has to, the total vacuum head that the pump has to create is nothing but equal to HS plus HAS, that is the acceleration head at the suction side. So this is the acceleration head. So acceleration head at the suction side is. Now since the water is accelerating in the suction pipe, there is HS, that the height through which it has to be pumped, and since it is accelerating, so the total vacuum that it has to create is nothing but HS plus HAS. So that is the total vacuum that the pump has to create so that the water comes inside the pump. So this is the pressure, this is the negative pressure or the vacuum pressure that the pump should create so that the water goes inside the pump. So we've seen what the effect of acceleration on suction side. Now let's see graphically how it looks like, what happens in the graph. We'll see through graph how it works. So as you can see, I've drawn the indicator diagram again. Let's try and understand the effect of the suction pressure and the acceleration HS and HAS on this graph. So this red line, as you can see, is the atmospheric pressure. This line indicates absolute vacuum, and when the piston is about to start, it is at this point, we all know that. Now when we drew the indicator diagram earlier, we had like a rectangle kind of thing, because that time we only had HS and HD. So now when I'm drawing the, we have already seen the effect of acceleration. Now so there is one more head that comes in, that is HAS, the effect of acceleration at the suction side. So when the pump is creating vacuum, it has to create vacuum that is equal to HS plus HAS. So this length, which was earlier equivalent to HS, after HS the pump, it used to compress up till 180, again it used to go up to this point. Now this was a diagram without the effect of HAS, that is the acceleration head. Now since we have acceleration head as well, it has to overcome both. So it has to create vacuum equal to HS and HAS. So this is how the graph looks like. So earlier the diagram was the black line that I've drawn. Now the diagram becomes a trapezium, as you can see here, the shaded region. So this is the diagram of indicator diagram at the suction end. Now we'll see that same diagram, the same effect of the acceleration head at the delivery end. So let's see the effect at the delivery end. So this was all about this topic, the effect of acceleration at the suction end and the graph. Now we'll see the effect at the delivery end and the graph of that. So I hope you've understood this topic. Thank you so much.